It is so wonderful to see so many families, homeschool families from across our diocese, all gathered together here in one place. So thanks so much, dear friends, for your presence here today. As we gather for this annual Mass for homeschool families, we note that the word faith is emphasized in several ways. First of all, we gather as we continue on that journey on the year of faith with Catholics throughout the world and with the leadership of our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI. We celebrate the feast today of St. Ambrose, a bishop who was known, as we heard in our opening prayer, as a courageous teacher of the Holy Catholic faith. And in today's gospel, when Jesus is approached and asked to perform a miracle, he says, "Let it be done according to your faith." And so let's begin by talking about the year of faith. We are celebrating that in so many ways throughout our diocese. But my young friends in Christ, I am sure that you would make your parents very proud, along with your bishop and Sister Rose, who is overseeing this year of faith in our diocese, if maybe you could tell me of some ways that you are celebrating with your families the year of faith. Would any one of the students like to tell me of some of the things you're doing at home to celebrate the year of faith? Any special projects or creative ideas you have come up with? Please tell me, or your parents will be so upset. Yes. That is wonderful. So one family is taking the year to travel throughout the year of faith to do missionary work. In other words, to bring the faith to others. What a great idea. What else are you doing at home or in your family to celebrate the year of faith? Where are we? Okay, someone way in the back. Could you stand up and tell me? Okay, maybe someone could. I'm having a hard time hearing you. Oh, very good. So celebrating the faith in Jesus through Mary, whose feast of the Immaculate Conception, Mary under the title of Immaculate Conception, we celebrate the vigil tonight and tomorrow. So that refocus on Mary. And throughout our diocese, so many projects to learn about our faith and to learn about the faith in this Diocese of Raleigh. We are doing a special emphasis on that famous priest, the first native priest of North Carolina, Father Thomas Price, whose cause for beatification and canonization has been uplifted. And so we hope, dear friends, that you're learning more about Father Price and more about the history of this diocese, how the faith has been spread, as continues to spread throughout the year. So keep up your good work. I always suggest to people throughout the diocese that there are three ways to celebrate the year of faith. I'm going to make it easy for you, students, because they all begin with the letter S. So when I ask you at the end of the homily, what are the three ways you can celebrate the year of faith, I want you to be able to answer me, okay? So the first way, of course, is to study your faith. And I want to thank your parents for making this a high priority in your home, not just during this special year, but always. We are to study our faith in this year, especially with renewed enthusiasm. Because how can we tell others about our faith if we do not know our faith? And how important it is, and your parents realize this, students, for you to know not only what the church teaches, but why the church teaches what she does in all of her beauty, in all of her wisdom. So please, never see the study of our faith as some sort of burden, but rather as a great privilege that God has given to us. In this year of faith, we promise also to show our faith by the way we live. In other words, we have to mean what we say and do what we promise. And if we are men and women of faith, then necessarily we have to be men and women of prayer. If Christ is truly the priority in our lives, then each and every day we give ourselves to the Lord in prayer, by being quiet, by allowing the Lord to speak to our hearts. And what an important reminder that is for all of us, especially this time of year, when we can be so easily distracted by things that are not essential. And finally, we show our faith. And we show our faith through charitable works and deeds. And this special time of year gives us so many opportunities to share our gifts and resources with others. And I'm well aware of how you are doing that in your families and in your parishes. And I am so proud of our diocese through its many works of charity to help others, because we know that whatever we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do for Christ Himself. So the year of faith, three ways we can celebrate it. First of all, we what, our faith?
Study.
We study our faith and we show our faith and we
share.
Excellent. St. Ambrose, a teacher of the faith, wise and courageous. And he taught the faith in a very difficult period in history, when there were many falsehoods and heresies, when people outright rejected Christ and the truth of his gospel. And yet, he persevered. In our world today, we see many similar ways of the faith being rejected. And that's why God has always promised that he would send to us courageous teachers of the faith who inspire us. And dear students, my young friends in Christ, the whole diocese today, we join with you in thanking God for blessing you with such wonderful parents who understand and demonstrate that they are the first teachers of their children in the ways of faith. And dear parents, I understand that that is not always easy for you, because your children live in a world in which the truth is often misrepresented and compromised. In a world that puts before them so many temptations and so many empty promises. And so, like Ambrose, you need the gifts of courage and prudence and wisdom, fortitude. Pray for those gifts at Mass today in a special way, so that you may return home today renewed in that commitment to be a courageous teacher of the faith, and so bring to your children the light of the gospel and the peace of Christ, whose birth we are preparing to celebrate anew. And in today's gospel, Jesus talks about faith. The blind men come up to him and they ask to be healed. They ask to have their eyes open. But what the evangelist wants us to realize and to focus on is not so much the physical cure of Jesus, but rather on the faith of those who approached him. Notice the only question Jesus asked them. Do you believe that I can do this for you? And they say, yes, Lord, we believe. And their eyes were open. Dear students, my young friends in Christ, what is it that you need Jesus to do for you? Maybe you need the Lord to open your eyes so that you see how loved you are by the Lord and His church and your parents and family and friends. Perhaps you need the Lord to open your eyes to see the gifts and the talents and the blessings He has given you. Maybe to open your eyes to see that God will never leave you, but will always walk with you, especially in your time of need. And the only thing Jesus asks of you, dear young friends, is do you believe that I can do this for you? And dear parents, what is it that you need the Lord to do for you? Perhaps you need the Lord to open your eyes to see that all those seeds you plant, that all those efforts you bring forth, that all those sacrifices you make will never be in vain. And that God will use them to produce good and abundant fruit in the lives of your children. It is my hope and prayer, dear friends, that this sacred season of Lent and this year of faith will be a source of abundant spiritual blessings for you and your families and all those you love. In a special way, may it be a time for all of us to renew our yes to the Lord. The Lord who longs to open our eyes and to work incredible miracles in our lives. May God bless you on this holy day and always.